Hello everybody. So I just left the house. I'm going to ground floor to look for some flowers because I'm having such a blue day. Now let's press the gift. Alright. It's on the second floor. Okay. But I'm not going to school today. I'm not going to school today because, well, I'm not feeling too well. So we're going to ground floor. Finally on ground floor, I'm going to pluck some flowers. Yeah. So today's topic is about Curvy women, and I'll tell you some struggles we Curvy women go through. But let me first put on my flowers. I need to be in a better mood. So here we are. Kuna mahua hapa. Check out my life. Slay boo, thanks, later. Okay, I'll just put it later. And then there's some orange flowers here. I saw some red ones. Well, well. Now time to fix my hair. This is gonna look so much like Snapchat. Done. Yeah, I know, they look amazing. Amazing. So let's talk about growing up as a curvy woman. When I was in primary school, I used to be bullied so much about my figure, and people made me believe that I was born by mistake and that I was so fat. I remember this one time, there's a guy in school who told me that I'm so fat. Alafu ako like matakwako ni kubwa funga kamba. This in English means your butt is too big. Use a rope, like tie it up. I wish even used English, not Kiswahili. My God, sometimes Kiswahili can be so savage. There's some birds on the background. Shut up, I'm recording. Those birds, though, shut up. Can you guys hear them? It is, no, it's crow. Anyway, so that happened when I was in primary school. And then after that, like I didn't have friends. Everybody was like, I'm fat. I look like I'm 20 something. That time I was around even 12, 13. But everybody was like, I'm fat. I look like I'm not really my age. And that pissed me off. It made me feel bad. Because, well, at that time, this curvy girl hype wasn't glorified. So it was kind of bad to be curvy. It was actually very sad. Yeah, I'm trying to look for light. I was going to the swings on that side, but there's no light on that side. It's a shade. Another thing I went through as a curvy woman was being told a thing. Something else is attention. You get so much attention when you're walking or doing anything. Sometimes people think it's okay, but it's not okay. Because like when I'm in town, I hate going to CBD. The conductors are just rogue. They call you all sorts of names. You don't talk to them, they insult you. They now make it look like it's something bad. Sometimes, like when I ask someone for money, they're like, so you become a socialite. If I was you, I would have sold my body. Well, I'm not you or you're not me, so yeah. Something else I go through, I go through slut shaming, yeah. And then there's this thing of like when I buy clothes, they don't fit me so well. Sometimes you buy something and at a year it can't go past this area. So my clothes are normally stretchers or skirts or dresses. But the problem is in my school, every time I go with a skirt or a dress, it's too short. Like because my butt lifts it up. So they're like, no, this is inappropriate for my school. If you're in my school, you know Daystar is just on another level of, like, you know, this whole dress code thing. So most of the time they're like, no, that's too short. That's another challenge we go through as curvy girls. Something else we go through as curvy girls is our self-esteem is not always so intact. Sometimes you see us with the curves and everything, you're like, yeah, those girls must be having everything. But no, sometimes it's too hard to dress this body. Sometimes it's too hard because, well, you know, Yanni, it's just crazy. I hope someone can relate to me, yeah. But then today I'm not singing, because as I told you, I'm in a bad mood. I actually didn't go to school because I'm not feeling so well. And well, yeah, so I'm just at home. That's why I wore pink. Pink, pink, my shoes pink. Because today is just a day to chill at home and just meditate because I don't feel so well. So pray for me, by the way. Thank you to all my subscribers and thank you all there who give me your comments and everything. They are just life to me, trust me. So I have to go back to their house. I'm glad I found time to vlog. You guys, don't I just look amazing with this? I wish it was just part of my hair. But every day I'll try and put this on. Yeah. So I think it's a wrap from me and my flowers. Till next week, I'll see you around. Remember to like, comment, subscribe. And remember, guys, it's Lent. So be good, do good, and always remember that someone has you out there. I love you so much. Oh, I wanna give a shout out to some people. Laura Seton, my boyfriend, Shiko, yeah, Shiko, you, the girlfriend of my cousin Alex, and everybody else.